And I would like to thank organizer for invitation. Today, I'm going to mention about one of the new techniques we use. That's glycemic analysis. That means the study of carbohydrate in order to find the new surface biomarker present in the human embryonic stem cell, and also in the cancer cell, especially in the cancer stem cell. And I would also like to demonstrate that this biomarker will be useful for the cancer and detection and also therapy. As you know, that the human embryonic stem cell represents the early embryonic development before gastrulation. That means that before formation of definitive tissue. In other words, we imagine that the surface marker present in the human embryonic stem cell most likely will not express in the normal tissue. And then we said that that's great for us to develop therapeutic agent or cancer detection, because there's not much site in a close reactivity. And as you know, the cancer cell also tend to differentiate, express an oncofetal protein. And therefore, our hypothesis is newly, unique, the surface marker present in the embryonic stem cell most likely to be found in the cancer cell. And for the past several years, we published many papers in the PNS or the stem cells, and demonstrate that there is a switch or expression pattern of glycoprotein and glycosphingolipid, as well as glycosylceramide transferase in the undifferentiated human embryonic stem cell. And today, I'm going to talk about some of the new marker we found, which are the cyanidated N-glycoprotein and also glycosphingolipid. As you may know, that on the cell surface, the 85% of the protein are glycosylated. In addition to protein, there are also phospholipids. Some of them are the so-called glycosphingolipid. And this is a new technology we use, and glycoproteomic analysis. We ask the chemical biology to synthesize sugar analog. They are incorporated through the biosynthesis into the cell. Then we also synthesize with the biotin biotin. Then using the click chemistry, they form a covalent binding. Then after enrichment, then enzyme digestion, they are subject to the LC mass analysis. And this is a profile for the N-glycoprotein present in the human embryonic undifferentiated cell, and also the embryonic stem cell that have been pushed towards the EB body. As you can see that there are 20 unique, the N-link, the cyanoglycoprotein present in the undifferentiated cell. On the Western blood analysis, we study at least 10 of them. They are highly expressed in the undifferentiated ES cell. After differentiation to the EB body, they disappear. On the other hand, we also found that these 10, the newly found glycoprotein are highly expressed in the so-called, the cancer stem cell. And you can see that they are, one of them, the ESCO2, which I'm going to talk about, in detail today, they are not fourfold more expression, sevenfold, or threefold more expression in the cancer stem cell. And this ESCO2 once it is knocked down, then the cell proliferation for the human ear cell has been arrested. And they also express in the mammary sphere of breast cancer. Once this glycoprotein has been silenced, the number of the mammary sphere is decreased. Furthermore, we demonstrate that if this glycoprotein, surface glycoprotein is silenced, then the so-called the OCT4 some of the the pluripotent gene will be expressed. On the other hand, the human ear cell will undergo spontaneous differentiation towards the endoderm and the mesoderm. It's demonstrated in the in vitro study, also demonstrated in the teratoma formation. If this ESCO2 is overexpressed in the breast cancer cell line or in the the PDS derived cancer cell line, then the tumor mass is increased. If it is silenced, then the tumor tumor formation in the transplantation is decreased. And from the data mining, it is also found that expression of this ESCO2 is increased in many types of tumor. And from the Kaplan-Meier analysis, you can see that if the tumor express this ESCO2, then the overall survival for the cancer is decreased. Therefore, we think that this unique the glycoprotein present in the undifferentiated ear cell can be useful for development of therapeutic agent. And we use the SCFV in the human library to develop the human antibody, therapeutic antibody against CO2, ESCO2, and we get 15 phage clones, which are unique, the amino acid sequence. Then we put this phage clone into the plasmid to generate the IgG antibody. Currently, we know that this antibody can suppress the cell proliferation of the cancer cell, and we also developed two different antibodies. And in the in vivo study, we use the PDS animal model derived using the human breast cancer cell injected into the NAS skin mice. As you can see, that after the injection, our control group and the tumor can easily be formed and developed. But with the injection of the two different antibodies, the tumor formation can be suppressed. The tumor size are decreased. In addition, this surface molecule has been secreted to the medium. Therefore, we think that once it is secreted to the medium, in the patient, the plasma, maybe they will generate the autoantibody. And they can be, therefore, we developed some ELISA tests in order to detect the presence of autoantibody present in the patient with breast cancer. As you can see, that the AUC is 0.85, and can also be, it's much better than most of the clinic, the biomarker. Clinically available. And in addition to the breast cancer, we also use the similar ELISA assay to analyze the plasma and the presence of autoantibody in the patient with the pancreatic cancer, the AUC is also very high, can be as high as 0.92 or 0.85. Therefore, this is ELISA assay can be a good discriminator, you know, to detect the cancer. Now I'm going to change the gear to talk about the glycolipid, the so-called glycosphingolipid. This is ceramide conjugated with the carbohydrate. And for the past several years, we published several papers in the PNAS and demonstrate that the profile for the glycosphingolipid, you know, are different between the undifferentiated ESL and the differentiated EB body. We have demonstrated that, you know, the during differentiation human ESL, there are changes from the global lactose series into the ganglion series. And there are several unique glycosphingolipid present in the undifferentiated ESL. They are also present in the IPS. But once they differentiate, this marker will disappear. Therefore, we are using this. We generate some microfluidity chip with a 23 glycan chip. Then they can be used to detect, you know, the presence of autoantibody, you know, for patients with breast cancer. AUC is 0.9. And one of the glycosphingolipid present in the undifferentiated cell is a global edge. Once differentiated EB body, they disappear. And the global edge is also a very good biomarker for the cancer. They are present in many, you know, the cancer cell, especially in the breast cancer. And currently, we initiated RSU in our institute, initiated a clinical trial in Taiwan for the randomized placebo control international phase 2 and 3 clinical trial using global edge as a cancer vaccine. This clinical trial currently ongoing in not only in Taiwan and also at UCSD, MD Anderson, and Hong Kong, and also and the Korea. And in summary, you know, our current study demonstrates that there is a big change in the expression pattern of the side-related N-link glycoprotein and also glycosphingolipid in the human ESL before differentiation. And this unique marker most likely do not express in the normal tissue or mature individual. Therefore, they are good for the cancer detection and also for therapy. And this is the last slide. You know, in our study, we have developed innovative technology platform to study the expression of glycoprotein and glycolipid in the human ESL. This new marker can be used to isolate the stem cell, but more importantly, we can use that to study the interrelationship between the stem cell and the cancer. And we are currently developing new methods for the cancer detection and the therapy. And we already push it to about phase 2 and phase 3 trial. And luckily, most of the study was carried out by Dr. Zhang and Dr. Liang. And the mass spec analysis has been helped by Dr. Ku. Antibody developed with the help from Dr. Wu, and RSU is the one who pushes the clinical trial, international clinical trial. Thank you.
Time for a couple of questions. Yeah, we can use those glycoproteins for detection. So you found that those only those the expression only in the mature cells. That how will you detect in the early as cancer?
You know the and those surface glycoprotein they express in the undifferentiated ear cell. As soon as they differentiate, they disappear. In the normal tissue, they usually don't express this glycoprotein in the normal tissue. And they also secrete into the medium. Therefore, they may generate another autoantibody. And because of the presence of the autoantibody, we can develop ELISA to for the early detection. You know, since this is newly found, you know, the glycoprotein, their biological function are currently unknown. But, you know, this is a good way for us. Once we demonstrate its presence, hopefully we can demonstrate its function, especially in the stem cell.